Freestyle. What we're going to talk about is the election that Trump just recently lost.
Yeah.
And what we're going to focus on is the conservatism, social conservatism, both political conservatism. One of the things I'll say just in the intro, I have a lot of Christian brothers and sisters in the United States and different channels over the world that are supporting Trump, saying, oh, Biden's the devil, this, that. But I look at the reflection of what does Trump really represent as a conservative? He's the most liberal conservative that's ever run what they call it, the Republican Party. How more liberal can you get than having a white person model that's shown her anatomy to the mainstream media? How more liberal can you get when he totally just opened free market economy as soon as he came in, reduced tax, just to name a few.
So you're to say that he's not liberal conservative,
to
say he's not a conservative at all?
No, he's not a conservative. He's he definitely lost the election because he was a person with liberal views. Representing a conservative party that had a Bible Belt social conservative following. And one of the mistakes he made was with his spiritual advisor.
Yes, Paula White.
Yeah, Paula White. Yeah. Now, Paula White is one of the most fantastic heretical Christians you can get online. I mean, she's a totally lost the plot.
And TV evangelist. TV evangelist.
So she has a great following, a cult following more like, and she's one of these kind of semi-idols. Now, to represent somebody in the height of power, in the White House, this woman was stomping around saying, when I walk in the White House, God walks with me. Now, this is a very dangerous talk because you got a lot of people that are intelligent in the United States that will watch their president be making a mockery of the religion and of the system.
And the sort of mainstream religion.
And the mainstream White House. How we can have a woman, a charlatan, walking saying, God walks with me in the White House in 2020. You will not even get a Hindu prime minister in India saying that. You'll not get an Islamic person saying that Allah is walking with you. You won't get that kind of nonsense from anybody in top office. But Trump really went against the broad scope of what's going on in the political world, and he's not going to be missed because the career politicians have taken out the golden boy or celebrity, and now everything going to get back together. That's my discernment.
I mean, he was always suppose the approach was always going to be a celebrity president, I suppose, isn't it? Really, billionaire, already known. So it's like, if you want. It was kind of an attraction. For instance, our president was kind of on his CV. It's kind of one more thing, at the bottom of his long history of kind of attraction. Well, one more thing to put on. I'm a billionaire, got money,
He got money, got everything. So now, to end your career, you end with prestige. So what would you call? Would you call Trump's presidency a failure or a success?
No, an absolute joke. Failure. As you said, I really don't. He's not going to be missed. He's absolutely not going to be missed. I mean, they're going to look back and sort of say, well, what are you going to remember?
Well, I think we'll be remembered for a wall that got knocked down during a hurricane. Even the wall he tried to build got knocked down by the elements. What else did he do? He created an X amount of jobs.
Yeah.
Everything was lost during COVID-19.
Yeah.
He's going to be remembered for 5 months of riots and civil disorder all over his
And really sort of engaging in the public in a way that you probably maybe wouldn't expect a politician to do, the way he engaged on social media and on Twitter. Really just going off on rants.
Well, the funniest thing, I do think Trump did leave a very fantastic legacy.
Right.
He found a cure for coronavirus because he's the only guy I know that one day after catching the virus, he was tweeting. Because I followed Trump on my Twitter. So he was tweeting in the hospital bed and he was out in 3 days.
Yes, and he did the jaunt, didn't he?
Yeah.
With his car.
And the shekel that they made of Cyrus, Wait, and Trump.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay.
For the first time, Jerusalem is the capital of Israel, officially by America.
Okay. Yeah, and you know what? Let's be fair. He's actually dismissed my narrative.
Okay.
Trump has done a few things.
Okay.
He did get into, when you talk about foreign policy, which is one, Jerusalem. That was a very important stance for him to take. The second thing he did, Kim Il-jun or whatever.
Oh, right, the North Korean. Yeah.
Now, he got dialogue with North Korea, and he stopped them making ballistic missiles to a certain
age.
which is a quite oil nuclear.
You think that's going to be an achievement that's going to be remembered?
Also, he also removed a lot of the United States troops out of Afghanistan, which was obviously a war they cannot win, and the Middle East, Iraq. So he has done some things in regards to US foreign policy, cutting down the budget on military expenditure by a couple of hundred billion. What else would you?
What would you say? I'm thinking. What would you say? What would you say would be expected of him to be remembered?
I think to be remembered, you have to leave a legacy.
Yeah, that's, I'm thinking of all the things we mentioned so far. Is any of them going to be remembered?
I think MAGA will be remembered, and I think the great thing about MAGA is that even the t-shirts were made in China.
Right.
So when you start off a kind of social construct with demagogues, make America great again, and you can't even create the goods in your own country.
Yes.
I think that was a standard to set for the failure that came about. And that's what they were not seeing. They were caught up on like a lot of demagogues, a lot of interesting ways of knocking
There's actually
out.
A joke in there somewhere, actually, because they say that something made in China doesn't last, doesn't it? It's kind of, there's definitely a joke in there somewhere. So is that for real? They were made in China.
Yeah,
they're definitely a joke in there, so it's not going to last.
Cheaper currency.